the void, but somehow different this time.
Surprised I can pull you into this place? The outsider marked me long ago. I made you flee your precious tower and turned your father into cold stone. How difficult for you. But when I was young, sweet Jessamine and I were closer sisters, sharing a secret. Emperor Caldwin had another daughter, born in shame to a kitchen maid.
Am I dreaming? If not, how is Delilah doing this?
I told you, dear, when you're older, I've sensed you.
You said that last year. Jessamine is younger than me, and she's a court every day.
Jessamine's, well, it's complicated. You'll understand someday.
What did I do? I'll be good, I swear.
Next year, I promise.
Jessamine and I played games in the tower, but at night I'd go back to the servants' quarters to cockroaches and thin gruel. Emperor Daddy would visit and tell me if I was good. Next year I'd be old enough to come to court to be a princess. Then one day, pretty Jessamine broke something worth a fortune, and the spymaster caught us. She claimed I did it, and he whipped me in the garden house until I bled. My mother lost her kitchen job, and that night we were out on the streets with no place to sleep.
I didn't break it.
Would you like to tell me your name?
We were just playing.
Emily and Jessamine. What is your account?
It was her. Delilah's life. She broke it.
I saw the nastiest parts of Dunwall, ending up in debtor's prison. Jessamine died quick on an assassin's blade, but my mother lingered for weeks after a fat guard broke her jaw. They threw me out when she died. I looked up at the lights of Dunwall Tower and swore revenge. Washing bedsheets in a brothel, I painted on the side, until Anton Sokolov took me as a student. That's the polite word for it. I was crafty even before the outsider marked me, and survived the worst the Empire could offer. Now, it's your turn.
My mother's sick. She needs help.
Your mother kicked off while you were out begging. She's another bag of bones now, girl.
What? No!
Your sentence is served and you'll be tossed out with the others. You can't stay here anymore.
It's hard to know whether my dear old aunt is telling the truth or not. When I saw what they'd done to Anton Sokolov, I wanted to hurt everyone who'd helped Delilah and the Duke of Sirkonos pull off their coup. Sokolov is the man who made whale oil into a weapon, who turned back the plague, and now he's barely able to speak. That painted the most powerful men and women of our time shake too badly to hold a spoon. When he does talk, he's going to give me a name. The next step along the way to Duke Luca Abel, then Delilah herself. A name. That's all I need. Wasn't a dream, was it?
Am I to blame for Delilah's bitterness?
All this is her doing, and she'll die for it.
Our decisions have weight. I feel my time drawing to an end. Soon.
Chindosh wanted me to help him with a rather complicated problem. It would have enabled him to make his clockwork soldiers at a fraction of the cost. Clever man.
Not clever enough. What's wrong with people like that?
A restless mind and an empty heart, perhaps. Chindosh would have snuffed me out as soon as he got bored. I appreciate what Emily did for me, freeing me from that place.
I searched for you, Anton. I would have found you.
I knew you'd try, Megan. They kept me going after they gave me to Chindosh.
Either way, you're back now. I'm glad.
Anton, you've had 3 days to rest. Tell me how to kill Delilah.
They tortured him. His body is covered with bruises.
Delilah has the throne, and my father is missing. This is Anton Sokolov, the greatest mind in the Empire.
No, Emily. Megan is right. I can make electricity move from one side of the room to the other, but Delilah is beyond my understanding. When I came to Cirkonos, I meant to leave everything behind. But when the assassination started, I couldn't ignore it. By the time Megan and I connected the murders to the Duke, it was too late. The Crown Killer came for me. It kept me alive from my knowledge, but I saw things. Chindosh often had a visitor, Brianna Ashworth.
She's the curator of the Royal Conservatory.
Yes, Ashworth is dangerous, as obsessed with the occult as Delilah. Apparently, she's working on a device called the Oraculum.
There's more to her than either of you know.
If Ashworth is one of Delilah's lieutenants, I need to eliminate her. Who knows what this device is capable of, or what she's up to?
For a man of his age, Sokolov's making better progress than I would have expected.
We'll take the skiff. I don't want to bring the dreadful whale any closer than we have to. There is a small dock in Syria Gardens, close to the conservatory. That's as far as I can take you. Ready to go?
Yes, let's go.
There'll be a Grand Guard presence outside the Royal Conservatory. Inside, be prepared for anything. Ashworth runs with an eclectic crowd. They'll be the real danger.
Someday I'd like to know more about how you met Ashworth.
I know you would. Trust me, Ashworth is important to Delilah. Which brings up something else. You might be able to exploit the Abbey of the Everyman in removing Ashworth from play. Turns out, the Vice Overseer in Karnaca has been watching Ashworth from a hidden outpost near the Royal Conservatory. Check it out first if you want more options. Remember, if she's still working with Delilah, Ashworth is a grave threat.
Thanks, Megan. See you soon.
old Duke Theodanus outlawed underwood export to protect the trees.
I can't keep track of all the decrees. My client... It's refurbishing her gazebo, adding an exotic southern touch.
I don't get it. When I went to Dunwall, I brought back a river crush shell to use as an ashtray. Because it reminds me of good times. Point of buying wood from a country you never visited.
Lady Sirshon.
This is bad!
Come back here! I'll kill you for that!
Greetings. Welcome to my shop. Say, an acquaintance of mine is supposed to be holed up in an office overlooking the Royal Conservatory. Check on them if you're headed that way. I'd check myself, but the streets are locked down. I'd make it worth your time.
I'll think about it.
See anything you like? What a pleasant surprise to see you again. I'm certain you'll be satisfied with your purchase. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. An excellent choice. Please visit again soon.
Say it twice.
Leave me alone!
Help!
Brianna Ashworth, curator of the Royal Conservatory. For a while, I believed Ashworth had some connection to the occult in Karnaca. Something is happening that I don't understand. The overseers are the forward face of the Abbey, but equally important are our sisters from the Oracular Order. To be direct, I suspect something is wrong within their sect. Subtle changes to the types of proclamations they've been making. Small but troubling deviations from tradition. But publicly saying anything along those lines will get me accused of heresy by my rivals within the Abbey. Is it possible that Ashworth has infiltrated the Oracular Order?
So Vice Overseer Byrne thinks Ashworth is interfering with the Oracular Order. If true, it's another reason she has to be eliminated.
Welcome back. Please, take your time. Bloodflies are worse here than any I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. Farewell, and do think of us again.
Find out what happened to Pearlton and Lieutenant Culver's?
They probably, if you ask me, must have had a thing for each other.
Yo!
Great.
Enrico said to give you his regards.
That donkey-faced cretin can open his wrists for all I care. Did you bring me something? The silver cigarette case, like we agreed?
No, listen, I won't steal anything else. I'm lucky to have room and board at one of the finest places in Karnaca. I can't lose this job.
Oh, really? You like being a servant? Polishing and dusting?
The place smells of lavender and antique furniture. Not like the dust district where the soot makes your teeth gray.
Is that anything to talk about? Got our stock vehicle? Too good to dust now. We'll see about that.
Anyway. he can't escape! End of them! Don't even pay for his...
Anyone here? Show yourself.
Where do you think you're going?
This hole.
Oh.
beat.
Where did you...
Stop!
Wait!
How did you do that?
What a pleasant welcome back.
Your acquaintance didn't make it.
A shame. In that case, I have a proposition for you. Recover the Roseboro prototype for me, and I'll pay you the finder's fee and something extra.
I'll think about it.
Take a look at what I've got for sale while you think. Come in, my friend. Always a delight to see you. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. An excellent choice. It was a pleasure to serve you.
Sleeps on a velvet pillow.
We
wicked name.
Oh. Where did you disappear to? To find out how a sword through the heart wasn't enough to kill our new Empress Delilah. These odd lenses might be linked to what Ashworth is working on.
Last night, I walked through a dream with one of them, and we drank from a fountain in the town where she was born.
Vice Overseer Byrne's suspicions were right.
Do now? I'm ruined. That feeling. The things I could do. The touch of the void. Delilah. It was everything I had.
Ashworth's journal might tell me more about why Delilah can't be killed.
advantageous marriage and years of childbearing. They promised me to a man three times my age who wheezed on about our wedding night. But a curious thing happened on the way to the altar, Delilah. From the first time I slipped out of the manor in the dead of night, there was no returning to my cage. Looking at the scars and drinking wine on a rooftop, I was free. Instead of seeing the overseer...
Mother, would I even be in this situation if you'd lived?
Thank you.
the Duke, who heard those same whispers. Together we worked to bring Delilah back into the world, changing the Empire from the home of Aramis Stilton 3 years ago. Across the aisles, all of us who'd been with her at Brigmore and before, we felt the magic return. Others joined. New faces, new blood. Now, Delilah is immortal. Forever. She holds Dunwall, and we've turned to corrupting the Oracular Order. The Overseers take guidance from their prophetic sisters, and soon we'll influence their dreams and visions.
who that was.
Come in, my welcome back. I see you found the prototype.
Your acquaintance didn't make it.
It is a risky line of work, I'm afraid, but let's not dwell. I expect you'll be interested in payment. First, your finder's fee, of course, and if you like, I can draw up some schematics based on the prototype, something you can use to modify your tools. And as a token of my appreciation, a discount at the shop.
A fair deal.
Welcome back. Please, take your time. An excellent choice. I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. See, I have some upgrade plans for your gear. The district is so quiet since the conservatory was closed. Farewell, and do think of us again.
You're coming tonight,
but I can fix it.
Go away. You've been warned.
So it's done.
Ashworth won't be a problem anymore.
Good. But Emily, there's something else. Back when I lived in Dunwall, I did things that I'm not proud of.
Isn't that a requirement for citizenship?
What I've got to say is not a joke. I knew Delilah and Ashworth. Bought into their bullshit. Which led me down a bad road. To be honest, before all this, I thought Delilah dead. I don't want to get into it right now. But I felt like you should know. There are things I regret.
You never know who to trust, do you?
Everybody makes mistakes, Empress. You'll have to tell me all your secrets someday. Are you ready to leave now?
For several years, Delilah's been here, getting stronger, turning people against me. Why didn't I see it coming? What was I doing during that time? Pretending to listen at court, ruling through an army of bureaucrats, waiting for the next chance to get free of Dunwall Tower. Well, now I'm free. If only I could go back. Aramis Stilton was once an ally of the Duke. The owner of Karnaca's mines, Stilton lives in a fortified bunker at the heart of the Dust District. No one's seen him for years, since around the time Delilah started making her moves. But whether Stilton's alive or dead, his home holds the key to Delilah's immortality.